Welcome to the STABcast, a podcast dedicated to Star Wars Legion. And commanders to the STABcast, the Sunsphere Tactical Attack Brigade Star Wars Legion podcast. I'm Ben, Robo Jazz Hands Fowler, with Will, Paint on His Hands Heim, Ryan, Children on His Hands Slawoski, and Tim, Idle Hands Hannon. Welcome, gentlemen.
So many hands.
Where will they all fit?
It's because in that all the stuff they've been doing that AMG's done this weekend is nothing but hands.
Yeah. You really think they would hire like some professional hand models? Maybe they are.
Oh, yeah. Those guys do not have professional model hands.
But why male models?
This week on the STABcast, so much news.
Yeah, that's it. We're just going to do a bunch of news.
Did you say the news?
The news.
Why, yes.
I don't know AMG well enough. Why do they call it a Ministravaganza?
Because like, it involves minis.
It involves miniatures.
Oh.
What do you mean? How do you not understand that?
Come on, English, like, bro.
Yeah, doctor in English, my ass.
So the spelling right now looks like minstrel extravaganza. So I'm pretty sure we're doing minstrel shows here. So.
Which also would be cool.
That would be cool.
I don't know that I need a minstrel extravaganza, man.
No, like, thank you.
That's
the Renaissance Fair is sweaty enough. I don't need more.
Oh, that's it. Now there's any reach the Renaissance. I'm with it.
We are an anti-Renaissance Fair podcast.
Are
okay.
We? All right, sure. I don't know. I enjoy a good Ren Fair. Well,
hang on. I do have a Henry VIII costume in my closet.
I know you
I'm
do.
I'm a Shakespearean man, not
but
I'm a Renaissance man.
Wearing that in the summer in Tennessee means you would die.
Oh, that's probably true.
Wearing any kind of clothing in the summer in Tennessee means you die.
Right, but if it involves
we're
a petticoat,
also not a nudist podcast.
Unless you want to be.
Unless
you're into it. Unless
listener,
into it.
I'm as clothed as you would like me to be right
subscribe
now.
Subscribe to our Only Legion to see the real STABcast unclothed.
Tim, yeah. we have played Legion in Texas. We have played Legion in Georgia. We're planning on going to play Legion in New Orleans. Come on. We've been to hotter places to play Legion.
No, I think Tennessee's the worst.
I mean, I've looked at playing Legion in Alabama. I'm not doing it.
Although I will say, Texas, it was rough to walk out of the restaurant after the evening, after the sun has gone down, figuring a cool breeze would hit you. And
it's still hot.
It's just like a convection oven. Just boom. Just boom.
Yep.
The ground absorbs enough that it stays a nice 88.
I like to be roasted both above and below. The underneath of me has been roasting. So,
well, enough about Ben's dark meat and how tender it is. We need to talk about the Ministravaganza.
Super tender.
There was Marvel, and it has been had.
Yeah, there was.
If you like some X-Men that didn't come out in the first wave, they're here now, and it's basically everyone Ben likes. So.
Yep. Honestly, yep. It's exactly why I didn't buy the MCP the first time. I was going to play out of Will stuff. Now I'm just going to go buy the stuff I like.
That's yep. Right, so. So that's cool and exciting. Hulkbuster, that's fun.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so I'm excited for those folks. And then we got some Star Wars. There was the X-Wing.
Just a little bit.
You know,
that
I think
X-Wing shakeup, that was surprising. Shocking.
Yeah.
It's not an X-Wing podcast.
Not yet.
Not yet.
I am slightly curious because I did not get to watch any of the.
That's crazy.
So X-Wing is doing a wave of stuff from the Mandalorian TV show. So sure. It's his ship and other such things.
And just random Mandos who leap out at you in space.
Yeah.
Like, I love it.
Troopers. Hell yeah. Space troopers. All right. Yeah.
It's a Mando bomb which throws Mandos at you.
So when
and they
I first,
fly around in space and shoot
when
you.
I first saw that card, I thought, because it has, you know, infantry on it, I was like, that's a weird-looking Legion card. Are we redesigning what Legion cards look like? And I had to read it. Nope. I was like, oh, no, that's an X-Wing card. Oh, okay.
That's an X-Wing card.
Okay.
Yep. They can board it you and make delightful. You, you know, have to defend less with less dice, or you can just take damage off of them with their rockets.
That's not the biggest thing
I love
for
the
X-Wing,
theme.
Though.
I love the theme of it.
That wasn't that wasn't the big shakeup for X-Wing.
No, they've announced a bunch of changes that I think we're going to lump together towards the end that because it seems to be a very similar design space for what they've done to a lot of Turn Zero things.
Yes.
And so...
Okay, fair enough.
We'll come back to it, yeah.
Yeah. And lots so, then, yeah, we came to the Legion.
Oh, the Legion. Yeah, and that's the game we play, guys.
That's the game we actually play.
There was a few things.
In theory, yeah.
We also got some news that we haven't covered on the show before the Ministravaganza, which honestly was kind of a surprise to me, but I thought they would just kind of save everything for a couple weeks and then unload it all at once. But
And what might that be?
We finally got spoiled to start with the infantry support platform. Full
the pizza card. Pie.
I thought that was during their stream.
It's the floating calzone.
Was it during the stream?
They gave us the box. We knew it was coming. But yeah, I was doing the stream this week that they
gotcha. I thought we got the weapons during the stream and the card.
No, they okay. The first yeah. they're it's like welcome to the Legion week, stream. Guys. It's this.
It has been. No, it's been a lot. It's been a lot.
They gave us all of it. They gave us all of it.
I had to message some of our locals who are very proactive, and I had to tell them. No, actually, Lando. I was messaging Lando. I was like, hey, just hold off. I'm gonna do a big super post because I know there's more coming. Because they said there's more coming, so just hold on. I'll get to it.
So yes, they started the stream, and the first thing they said was, "And here's the infantry support platform card." And here it is. My God,
it's glorious.
It is.
It's glorious.
This is not at all what I thought was coming.
Will, no. What does it say, Will?
Well, this infantry support platform is a single model unit of the heavy rank.
Yes, it is not a support platform, as the name would imply.
No, it's misleading.
Well, it does support the infantry by blowing up the opponent.
Yeah. Yes. It is 65 points base.
That's by a country, not a country mile. That's Surge one of the cheapest. It is the cheapest heavy we have, next to the Rebel X-34 at 75.
For the following on the card, it is armor 3.
Gross.
Cover 1.
Gross.
Yes.
Four hits block.
Hover ground.
Ooh, strafe reverse standby.
Yeah, which is not speeder. It's not a speeder.
Yeah, the standby's pretty key here, and the fact that it's not a speeder, so you don't have to move.
And then we have weak point 1 side rear,
which seems bad that it's 75% of the model is weak pointed, but when it's weak pointed cover 3 armor or cover 1 armor 3. Not so bad at that point.
It's not great, but it's what it is. Fine. I don't think it's fine. For what you're paying, I'm okay with it having a downside.
Absolutely.
Then we have a surging white save that protects 7 health, breaking at 5 wounds.
Seems real good.
Yeah.
We have surge hit to go along really with that good. Surge block.
Yes.
Speed 3.
Speed 3 is wild to me.
Yes.
And it's really going to determine also like what size base this thing is on, to how fast this thing actually is.
So you mean strafe 2 is what you mean?
Yeah,
strafe is 1 speed lower, but it's still large.
I had not thought about that till you said it.
So you're right though. Weak point sides, but it'd be a real shame if you never got to see my sides.
I'm just doing donuts in this parking lot, so you can't shoot me.
It may equip a pilot, a hardpoint, and a comms upgrade.
Mm-hmm. Which, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think this is a common theme with some of the things that we're going to be moving through here. This is a really modest upgrade bar.
It is.
Yeah, it is.
It is.
Like, some of the new stuff I've been really surprised with, like, they're putting a lot more on the cards and a lot less empty upgrade slots.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's pretty much the same as the LAT, except instead of an ordnance, you get that hardpoint. Yeah.
Right.
And then you're going to want to use those because for your basic weapons, you have the guys sitting on it have their DC-15 rifles, which is 1-3, 2 black, no keywords.
Pew pew.
Yeah. Surge hit.
Pew pew. Yeah. Surge hit.
It's still surge hit. It's still surge hit.
So. If you want nothing else than a pure fire support platform, I mean, there you go.
It does support the infantry
like
network.
A dirt and cheap fire support platform.
And those aren't arc limited. And so... It is a fair point, since you could bring a 5-point pilot that makes the fire support even scarier.
Yeah, 5-point surge crit pilot are 325th Star Corps elite armor pilots. I just wanted to say Star Corps.
Star Corps.
Is this, again? Do you think this is going to be our only pilot in the box? It's the only one they showed us.
No, I think there'll be another one.
I think there'll be another. Somebody named. Somebody weird.
There is another. I don't know.
Yeah. Probably Gree from the Khajiit Troopers.
It should be stated, you only get search crit if using fire support.
Right.
So yes.
If someone else is shooting unit, with you, then you suddenly get search crit.
Yeah. The power of friendship.
Suddenly you're Rex.
That's right.
They continue making Republic pilots. Stop right there. That's really good compared to the ATRT.
Yeah, it is.
Like, if I'm looking at a fire support platform, I'm getting to throw slightly better dice.
Yeah.
I have a couple more hits. I surge hit and defense.
They're both 65, but now for only 70, again, if you want nothing else, you still have a range 1 to 3 surge crit platform.
The only reason I'll say the ATRT might be a touch stronger in that, like, just purely naked, you're not going to take this thing or the ATRT probably naked very often.
Sure.
But if you did.
That RT Rider has scout and he's got some, is it critical and impact on his weapon?
Yes. Crit one, impact one.
That's pretty good.
And it's black, white, white, so it's got more potential for hits.
Yeah. But like, anyway, no one's going to do that, so we can argue about this.
Moving on.
Because they immediately proceeded to show us three weapon options that fill that hardpoint slot. All of which cost the same at 40 points.
Convenient.
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty okay with it. I think it was a little high, but we'll get to that.
Nah, I think it's about
so
right.
So wrong.
It's a touch high.
It's not high.
I'm just glad they're all the same rather than having to make us choose, like, you know, this one that's 3 points less and whether that makes it worth it versus the others. And it's like, no, just let me pick based on purely what the colors and words
and
do.
And what I want to do,
Yeah. Really, all really strong weapons.
All of them twins. Hashtag twinning.
Hashtag twinning. Ben, which is your favorite?
All right. I'm going to be a twin blaster cannon because that's the style of ATRT that I tend to play.
That's true.
Started blasting.
It has 6 black dice at range 1 to 3. critical 2, fix to the front, which is perfectly fine because you can always slew around with that speed 2.
You're fine.
But here's the thing that I love about it. When you activate, you may have this weapon's dice and keyword values until the end of your activation, and if you do, you gain Gunslinger.
Yep. There's 2 guns.
That is great. Like, you've been in that place where you've got to pick up, you either need 2 suppression here, or you got to just knock off 2 units because they're down to a couple bodies, but you hate to waste the shot with overwhelming dice on a single body. So, like, you know what? I'll just Gunslinger. 3 dice over there, 3 dice into that unit leader.
Right. Each with crit 1.
Yep, crit 1. Yeah, or if you're fire supporting with a pilot, each surge crit in that whole pool.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So if you want to spend 3 activations at once.
I mean, sure, but if you want to delete 3 activations, you might go pound for pound. No,
it's
I don't know, though, honestly, how often you're gonna be using this feature because you are cutting the dice in half.
Yeah. Right. I think it's
3 black dice is like, the flexibility is certainly welcome. But like 3 black dice is maybe if you can catch something out like B1s or white save troopers out of cover.
Yeah.
Sure.
Or you really want to play the suppression game. Which as we've talked about before,
I love playing the suppression game.
Has fallen out of favor a little bit.
Ben does love his suppressions.
I do.
So we'll see. We'll see how much you actually use the Gunslinger. Now, I think the place to use the Gunslinger is if you do have that Star Corps pilot and you want to burn those 3 activations, bang, 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 just to really light something up really quickly.
Well, and it should be noted. 2
surge crit attacks instead of 1.
And it should be noted.
2 13 die pools with surge crit on each one,
The platform does not have arsenal. So you have
correct.
To.
Correct. So
you cannot just throw in 2 extra black dice.
You're not going to be using your 2 black dice in there. Oh, bother.
Yeah.
No, but you know, it's not 8 black.
I've seen, GAR players who have units who are suppressed or may panic. And so you use them for fire support advantage.
Sure. Yeah.
Yep.
I mean,
it's a tactic.
They save another turn.
It's a thing. Yeah. Totally a thing.
Oh, yeah.
But we got two more weapons. 2 more weapons.
Tim, which one's your favorite out of the bunch?
Well, it's not my favorite, but I'll talk about it because this is how it works. It's the truth.
You lie, Tim. You lie to the listeners. Come on,
I don't lie to the listeners. I tell them the truth. From upon the throne, I speak truth. But
this is my throne. Get out.
The twin beam cannons. The beaming.
The beaming. It's range
1 to 4. 2 red, 2 white. Beaming. Two red, two white. Remember, Surge hit still.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Beam two. So you're getting three, two red, two white attacks. Surge hit at range four, which is
if you can cascade. Like
that. I mean that there's four yeah. dice each attack. You're throwing 12 dice here.
I think
that's two red, two white, but you do surge.
Well, and I agree with what Will was saying, where it's nice that they're all the same price because you don't have to play mm-hmm. that game like, well, is this worth it? Because now, again, you can just figure out how does this support platform, how does it best support my army? So if you want to do the fire yep. support shenanigans, you can do the twin blaster cannons or, spoiler, the twin missile pods. Like, do something like that. But if you want it just to kind of either run around on its own or be in the backfield, something like that, you can bring the beam cannons, and that's okay. Yeah. It doesn't change anything.
Can carve up a flank like a turkey.
We've made fun of beam before and how kind of ineffective it really can be. But I think this beam weapon is going to be better than what we've seen before in the Republic arsenal from either the saber tank or the command card. Yeah. In the fact that this is a beam weapon, I think the first time we've had a minimum range of one.
Yes, I think so.
No, the tank one.
Oh,
is the tank is one to four.
Oh, is it one to five? Okay.
But it's only two red dice.
Yeah, yes. The problem with the tank one is that it's two red, and that means dice. Heavy cover is just lol.
Lol.
Yeah. Right.
And the combination of strafe to get around cover to really make these dice mm-hmm. effective.
Well, and the saber tank one costs like 35, and the other gun for the top is 15.
It costs 30.
For better dice. Yeah, right. Sorry.
So
for 10 points more, you get the two extra white dice.
Right.
But that makes a lot of difference.
Yeah, and an extra beam, I think. Isn't the saber only beam one?
I think
it's
beam two.
It's supposed to be beam two. Is it beam two?
Okay. It's beam two.
But what's fun, though, is you can do this, but then also you could have your clone commander, like, you could play this on your air support turn and potentially just be beaming, like, half the enemy army.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a good time.
Especially if you get if you have a few twin beam equipped support platforms and they're going to run up and...
And these things are cheap enough. Like, I think you can make a solid, like, double heavy list for Republic.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely. They're 100 point, like 110 each. It's,
115, yeah.
Yeah, depending on what other pilots we might get.
Nah, but the real juice here, as we have...
in your opinion, but okay.
As in the current meta state, which who knows what the meta will be like when these things actually wash up on our shores...
That's a good way to put it.
The twin missile pod, range 2 to 4, 4 red dice, impact 2. Mm-hmm. Same gunslinger, splitting keywords as the above, where you can cut your die pool in half, cut your impact in half, and make 2 attacks. But 4 red dice impact, anytime you see multiple impact, I think is a great. But butted behind 4 red dice, you know, because that's pretty good at killing infantry too. Is pretty rad.
If
it is flexible.
If the Star Corps elite armor pilot didn't exist, I would agree with you.
Okay,
but I don't know why you would run that. If you're thinking about anti-armor stuff, I don't know why you would run that. If you're gonna run the core pilot, the elite pilot, I'll just call him the elite pilot.
Just because you're not fire supporting, I don't think every round.
Well, sure, but you have a huge dice pool. Huge die pool with surge crit is real good. I've one shot
until you don't get surge.
Until you don't get it. Yeah, I've played the ATRT enough where you just pull the slot machine with 5 black dice and you're like, oh boy, here we go. And that's why the heavy laser cannon on the RT exists, because you can't rely on that, just that pure surge crit ability.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
I will say the twin missile pods is going to work really well against those B2 Haas.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, it will.
Because impact 2 automatically triggers even though they have armor 1.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah, I think it's real good in today's meta. I think I do like the 6 black die. The beam, I think, is you're going to have players that really like it. I'm not one of them. Power to you guys. I don't think it's a bad choice.
Beam power.
But I think getting
those 4 dice per attack, moving up from 2 red to 2 white, I think is what's going to make the difference on that thing.
And again, the surge hit should not be understated, because you have something like the tank.
Yeah.
The tank doesn't surge hit, right? So, like, it has beam too, but you don't, you know, you have to rely on tokens and things.
I did wonder if
this was somehow an accident and not supposed to be a heavy, because 105 points at a base... Because you put that weapon on it. I mean, that really is an AT-RT.
But it's a weak heavy, though. I mean, health-wise. Like, it's 7 white dice.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's bad, but I'm just saying, like, if you compare it to other heavy units, it's the weakest heavy unit as far as
it's actually not goes. Tim,
is it not? What's weaker?
LAAT has 8 health. I mean,
well, yeah,
it's the X-34 without X-34 a shield
has
droid.
X-34 has 7.
X-34,
okay.
Or the X-34 has 6. Is it 6?
I thought it was
it's
7.
It's 6.
Yeah.
Okay, okay, fair enough.
And then the
enough.
T-47 yeah. is full armor, but it also has 7.
Yeah. But it's full armor, so, though, so I think it's, yeah.
That does make a difference.
Yeah, I think at cover 1 armor 3, I don't know how
yeah,
much of a difference
it makes. Cover 1 armor 3 might as well be full armor. Really,
yeah.
Just about.
It's except for when you get fire supported.
It's a really cool unit. I can't wait to see what it does. I immediately when I first saw the stat card, wanted to start drawing comparisons to the X-34 because they're similar health, similar point cost.
They similar do different kind of, things, though.
They do incredibly different things.
Yeah, I don't think that's a fair comparison at all.
No, it's absolutely not.
Yeah.
But
this really is a fire support platform.
It really is.
Yeah. I
mean, to make the pun.
But again, you know, like we said, if you want to run it cheap and flank with it, that's fine. You can do that. You can live that life. That's all right.
Yeah, and I'll be very anxious to see if we get other pilots what they might bring to the table to alter fire support maybe in some other
way. I think I'm glad they're heavy though and not support because bringing 3 naked would kind of be oppressive if they're on a huge base and they're speed 3ing around the board.
Yeah,
that's true.
On certain objectives like bombing run. That could be a problem.
Yeah, but these things are, you know, white saves,
right?
So they are going to be fragile enough if you have an answer, that you'll be able to really focus one of these guys down.
Yeah, this is not the AAT that you stick in the middle of the map and be like, take it all.
Yeah,
no.
All right, that's enough. That's enough. Clone throne.
Clone throne.
You got
never
a,
dies.
You got a lot of news.
Yeah. Speaking of the AAT and the droids.
So
yeah. I'm not a droid episode. Player or anything. Jeez.
Not yet.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Remember, guys, in the Wayback Machine, if we were just to go there for a moment, when we started this show and we were all going to be like, we're all going to play a faction and talk about things from our unique perspectives. Well,
sorry, I like Legion in other ways too.
We still
Ryan
have,
remembers.
We still have unique perspectives. We can have a unique perspective about the same faction.
We're all uniquely wrong in our own way.
That's right.
Ben, tell us what's uniquely wrong now.
In the last episode, this is where we lost Ryan. He lost all of his files. So what you caught was just Will and I talking about the new things we had for droids.
Yes.
And it was a lot of things. Even though we lost half the episode, Will and I spoke for nearly 40 minutes.
Yeah,
like we had a pretty lengthy amount of time there.
Yes.
And so we got more news. Like, I can't even believe there's this much news out there.
Yeah, I know.
Now,
it's a lot.
Now, what this means is I'm not going to see any of these units until January of next year.
Probably.
however long that boat is, I'm never going to see this thing.
Yeah.
Europe will have been playing with it for 6 months.
You can get it on eBay for $80.
Yes.
Worth it.
You know, we got... You know, I was going to go there, but I'm not. I'm going to go to the Dwarf Spider Droid because I love it. So.
Okay, so we're going to start with the Spider Droid.
This is a very big
But I love the NRN99.
And we're going to come back to it because I do love it. But we got what the actual weapons on the Dwarf Spider Droid do.
Yes.
We did.
And more importantly, what its
And the program
cards.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, last show we talked about the unit card.
Yes.
And
yes,
how
we did.
It's Which... an ATRT.
By the way, it only has one hull less than the the infantry support platform.
Yep. It doesn't have cover 1, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. Nope.
It does not. But I want to get shot. It's like, shoot me. Shoot me, you coward.
What if it was nimble, though?
We'll get there.
So,
slow your roll.
Those who don't remember, it surges, you know, attack and defense, 6 hull, 4 breakpoint, white dice, has the armor 3, climbing vehicle, expert climber, which I just love, 55 points. It has the explode, the self-destruct 4. Once it has at least 4 wound tokens, it can blow itself up.
Three red dice, impact one. To everyone around it.
Dice.
I'm going to break the self-destruct weapon when you break a weapon.
It no, goes to 2 red dice.
Oh, it's only if you're engaged with it, though. That's sad. It should be range 1. No, the self-destruct is engaged.
It is range 1.
Oh, is it? Okay. It says self-destruct mechanism.
It's just also versatile.
Engaged. Okay, I see. Okay.
Yes.
Perform an attack against each unit at range 1 and in line of sight.
at range. Oh, see. Okay. That makes sense. Okay.
Yeah.
And the engaged icon, the if you look at the range indicators, they are different symbols.
Oh, yeah,
they
look are at that.
Much it's... like many of the Legion symbols. Very similar, but they are yeah. very yeah. similar.
You see, the melee one has two lightsabers, and the self-destruct is more of just a hexagon.
So what else have we found out about this thing?
So the greatest thing, and the thing I think I love the most, and I don't know why I love it.
That it is not without sin.
It is. I am not without sin. It is the nose-mounted ion blaster.
God, it's so good.
It's so good. God.
Good lord.
For 10 points, I can equip this to a little 55-point walking spider.
65 points.
Range 2-4, 3 black dice, 3 white dice, exhaust a fire, but no worries, guys. It has cycle.
Like, off.
Yeah.
Ion 1 and Impact 2.
Impact 2?
Ion 1, Impact 2. So you're probably almost certainly getting that impact or that ion through because you do have to do damage.
Because remember, you got to do the wound to get the ion, which is always a problem.
Right.
But it's also 6 dice, so you're probably going to get 1 crit.
Right.
6 dice, yep. You're going to surge somewhere in there. Yeah.
I mean, you already surge hit. Yeah. Yeah. It's so good.
I'm saying you should get. You should get one natural crit, and then if it's into armor,
my question is this: because of this one combo here, just everything like the Spider Droid with the ion gun, do you ever see an ATRT again?
Yes, because we can't take it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. You take the range 4 ion or the range 4 RT gun, and you just kill it with fire from a long way away.
I don't think that works, but okay.
You try.
Or
you
they try. Are both climbing vehicles, and you find the tallest piece of terrain, challenge each other,
and challenge them
combat.
To a duel.
But the Spider Droid wins.
ATRT kick and Wicked kick each other.
The Spider Droid wins. It's a free. You're starting to win this battle. I'm just gonna die.
Kapow.
It's only impact one.
It's only impact one.
But that could be enough. Could be the stuff.
Could be,
now,
that's the weapon. No, you're wrong. There are other weapons which I also equally love because they are very much built like the ATRT,
yes.
which is a vehicle I've always liked.
Yes.
I've always liked that.
I think our Dallas reporting revealed that I am a lover of the Flammenwerfer.
Yeah, the Flammenwerfer.
Tell me about the nose-mounted flamethrower.
We have the nose-mounted flamethrower. It's range 1 because, of course, it is. But it is red white.
Oh god.
With blast and spray as a flamethrower should.
Yeah.
Yep. Seems
for
good.
For a measly 15 rather than 10
points. Oh my god.
And so I know theoretically the math says the black die versus the red white die.
Sure.
But I can always dream of the day the white dice come up exactly right.
Well, yeah, searching, you know what happens. Searching hit black dice like
yeah.
Yeah, it's white the dice, yes, yeah. The ATRT one is a smidge stronger. But
I feel like however many red dice, I mean, are pretty solid.
Yeah.
Black dice are.
It's giving you
black
chances.
Dice are,
yeah. It's going to swing harder. It's going to hit harder.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this thing gets to follow up if you're in flamethrower range. I hate to break it to you, but you're in self-destruct range as well.
Yep.
Well, not only that, if you bring Kraken, is it Kalani? Sorry, whichever one. Oh, any of them. Sorry, that's right. It's a command card. You can just give it the reinforcements and just reinforce with it. That's fine.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
This is fine. So now you're putting yourself right there, you know, where you can just run into the enemy. Wait,
right where I need to be. Yeah. Tap, tap, tap. You better shoot me quick, boys, because I'm going
to
flame.
What if you're being forced to? Oh, well, we're not there yet.
I've never feared the droid v. droids matchup.
Now you will.
I will. I mean,
now you will. Those,
and he was a very nice man. We played at LVO. I like him a lot. But you know, it was. I never had like, oh, how am I going to do this thing? Because I knew what the list was going to do.
Right.
Because he and I were playing. But this, if I see that thing with my droids, I'm like, well, B2s, go shoot it. Shoot it quickly. Shoot it. I said shoot it quickly. Oh, God. Put it out.
It's also not bad against B2s.
Yeah.
No. It's not.
It's the Uruk Hai thing, like in Helm's Deep, where it's just, yes, take down exactly. that orc. Take down that spider droid.
Yeah. I kind of need the handprint on the spider droid's head.
Oh,
now.
You can do it. You can do it. We can get Will to do it. Yeah,
I'm paying Will to paint these.
Can we just put a little bit of white paint on Daisy's paw and just stick it to the model?
Stop it. I love it.
The white paw of Daisy.
I mean,
whom
I'm going to have
do you serve, anyway. Daisy?
I'm down.
For those that don't know, Daisy's Will's cat.
Yes.
You've heard most Daisy a couple times on the podcast.
You never know. Yeah.
Listen, I've mentioned Daisy's Instagram here before. I plugged it once.
Someone at Lone Star asked me how Daisy was doing, and it did take me, like, I was taken aback a little bit. Just like,
How dare you ask about my child?
Just like, your cat
is just as internet famous as Brett. How does that make you feel?
Sorry for Brett.
Sorry for Brett. But here's the thing. As much as I love those two weapons,
what if you're
I'm
vanilla?
More likely to play this third one.
Yeah, the third one is the vanilla.
But that ion one, Ben, oh my God.
I know it's a vanilla choice, but I just love that dice.
It's solid.
I love that range.
It's so solid.
I love that crit one.
He just loves a hand-cranked Southern-style vanilla ice cream.
I do, actually, yeah. Little peaches on the side. I think because this is peaches on the side.
It's mathematically the same pretty much as the AT-RT weapon. One red, one white, three black. So it equates out to, you know, five surging black dice. Fixed front,
except you get crit one too.
Seems good.
Yeah.
Is that accurate?
Yes.
Seems good. I think Ion being the cheapest option is just bananas.
It's because it taps and there's actions you might be having to do instead of...
Yeah, theoretically, exactly. On the advance, you've got
to... Yeah, once we talk about protocols, you're not going to be able to... Readying this thing will be more difficult than one might think.
Unless your super tactical says ignore AI.
Yes, exactly. Unless you override it.
There's also that. or I just give an order token. It's perfectly fine, guys.
Exactly.
Two steps and a spider droid coming right at you.
I've already thought about it. I've already been building it.
We got our three protocols.
We got attack protocols. In the previous episode.
In the previous episode, we already got attack protocol. So, yeah, you have AI aim and precise two. Seems good. Three points.
Oh, it's gnarly.
Yeah.
It seems great.
So something they talked about on the stream was the design for these, that I really enjoy the card art. And they did talk about how attack protocols, they did make sure to give it those angry little eyebrows.
Angry eyes.
Grr. I love it.
But, I mean, if you're just going to sit back at range three and throw those five dice from the laser cannon.
Yeah.
Yep.
You don't
AC
care if you're forced
AI
to aim.
AI aim and precise two?
Yeah. Oh,
so good. But for 3 points, and so we said, all right, so the defense protocol will probably be we'll get a dodge, and the engagement will probably be a move. Cool. Except this defense protocol is amazing.
I'm in danger.
Oh my God, is it amazing.
Yeah, it really is.
Yep.
So it's 3 points. It's 3 points, and you get AI dodge. Okay, we all know AI dodge.
Cool. Right. That seems good. I don't think there's anything else.
No, but what if we also gave you nimble and outmaneuver?
What?
I love the idea of my little spider droid just dancing. Just like tap it up, tap, tap, tap it up, tap, tap, tap. As he's getting shot.
I mean, you can say that. I'll be honest. We'll talk about where this thing goes in a minute. I do not think you put this on the spider droid.
And no, like, I think it has a certain place that it goes.
I think
it has a place that we're all thinking about.
I think it has a place. I think you can put the other two on the spider droid. I don't think this one goes on the spider droid.
So I mean, I just want to walk a 58-point bomb towards the center, and I just need to survive long enough on my way there.
Then you don't want steps.
Yeah.
And I don't want steps. It's fine. 58 points. I mean, because it is enough of a threat. Will, you and I talked about this, a nearly naked AT-RT or an AT-RT with a flamethrower. It's a really big, I got to go kill that thing as soon as I can. Like, and so for 58 points, if this guy's drawing aggro, I love it. I do. Yeah. If it's just 58 points, you decide to run that route. I mean, it could be defense protocols, attack protocols, all cool. So engagement protocols is just, you know, AI move, right? We're engaging and walk up close to him.
Or... AI attack.
I'm real surprised they gave us that as a protocol.
But Ben, it's 2 points more.
you're paying for that flexibility, and there's no special rules, there's no special cool stuff.
You don't get like AI move with agile or something. You know, it's fine.
Again, you put engagement protocols on a laser cannon, you know, spider droid. You're sitting at 75 points. To go pew 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 pew.
You don't get to aim, but that's okay. You'll just take a dodge.
We're just gonna walk forward.
Take a standby.
Just walk forward.
Yeah.
Shoot me.
I think this goes on a flamethrower.
This goes on the flamethrower.
So you can
absolutely.
Move.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Again, 75 points.
Yeah.
Seems real good. Spider droid.
Pretty good.
Six thumbs up from Stabcast.
Yep, gonna buy three for my droid army. I mean, fuck.
So Ben, if we're talking about defense protocols, and we said it doesn't maybe go on the spider droid every time, what would it go on? Please tell us.
Listen to last week's episode, I think this is where I sold Will on joining the droid army, because the snail tank. Is a snail tank.
God, that snail tank.
You said I want to build a snail tank, Ben. I was like, well, you're going to build mine, but you know, I'll buy you another one.
Subscribe to our only legions to see our real feelings about the snail tank.
Snail tank senpai.
Oh, senpai protocols.
Yep.
It is the NR-N99 Persuader class tank droid.
Yes.
145 points. Full armor. Arsenal 2. Programmed, so you gotta equip one of those programming cards.
Oh, those cards that aren't very good, yeah.
Oh no!
Yeah, reposition, which is nice, because you know, we're on that lozenge, big old, you know, angle. Or
Tim, does the Gav have that? Just curious.
It does.
Okay, yeah, just making sure they didn't screw you that hard.
No.
It does have that. No. Transport 1 open. Because we talked about this probably was going to happen, but because you know, you got B1s right on the side, but I love it.
It's not for the B1s, but yes, go ahead. Yeah. It's something darker.
It is not.
Something darker rides.
Weak point one sides. Yeah. Okay. It's got big open sides there. That kind of makes sense.
It's fair.
You can equip the programming card. You can equip a missile, a comm slot. Because, you know, we're all droids. We get the comm slots. It has 11 health.
What?
A 7 break point. White defense die.
The white save kind of caught me by surprise. I'm not going to lie.
Well, yeah,
it's
but
surging.
You surge.
It does surge, but still.
It's like an ATST.
It does surge defense.
Yeah.
It's like an ATST.
It is.
They just gave it more health.
Not quite as tall, but.
But no, like, after getting the 9 tall point tall AAT.
The red save 9 hit point.
Yeah. Monster.
It's a different flavor.
Different flavor of it. Speed 1, but you got that big old, you know, big old base there, oval. You're going to flop around, reposition where you want to, move forward.
Flop.
I love it. But, you know, the Arsenal 2. So you've got the basic cannon, which is exactly like the E-Web cannon. It's red, 2 black, 2 white.
Yep.
Crit 1, fixed front, range 1 to 4.
But does surge hit.
Then there's the weapon that changes everything.
I couldn't believe it had it on there. Like,
the first time we've seen this.
I was like, excuse me?
Yep.
It has ion cannons as its other weapon. Range 1 to 2, rainbow dies.
Yep.
So, you know, red, white, and black. Impact 1, ion 1, fixed front.
Non-tappable ion is here to stay, boys and girls.
And with that thing, you can get range 1 to 2 real quick.
Yeah.
And well, you see, I was always a droid player, really.
And here's the thing, too, is with I know it has weak point and sides, which as a Gav person, and I've played Gav before, not so much anymore, but back in the day, they can sneak up on you, but hey, if you got some defense protocols, you don't give a shit.
Yeah. Go with them early, sit there with that nimble. Like, the fact that a vehicle can get nimble and outmaneuver.
Yeah. So, that one impact? Armor. Yeah, it doesn't.
Oh, did those rebel troopers roll that one crit? Ha! Anyways.
I couldn't believe it. I was like, oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, because the droids are really hurting right now, you know.
The poor droids need to be uplifted.
Man.
Do you even have to put an ordinance on this thing?
No. I mean, you don't
have to, but you can if you want to.
You can have a high energy for that first time you shoot and ions aren't in range yet.
Or you bunker buster and then let your maybe Darth Maul, who's riding on board, jump out and melee someone that you just
scattered out.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, man. I can see that. Sword commandos riding on board to drive closer and hit you with
their
swords.
I think that's fair, too. There's a lot of options you can put on this thing that the droids are okay with. Put some B2s on there. That's fine. Like, so many options.
Then they're just chilling in heavy cover armor 1 while they sit on the sides of the tank.
Yeah.
I mean, if you really want the armor-piercing shells for 10 points.
Sure.
That's, you know, 2 red, 4 black, 2 white, surging hit, crit 1, impact 3. I mean, that's a really good dice pool for things on range 2 to 3 as you move in to get within your range 1 to eye on something.
It's so like good.
Like the droid army.
And also, to be fair, we should say, the model's gorgeous looking.
Yeah, the models with everything they showed off.
Super pretty. Great. Yeah.
Yeah.
I got no complaints there. That's good.
I mean, the defense protocols on that thing is amazing. if you just want the engagement protocols, attack or move, yeah. I was going to do one of those two things in whichever order I wanted.
I was
going to
do it anyway.
Yeah.
145 points. And so there's been a lot of comparison to the Gav tank. There's been a lot. There has been. Although Tim doesn't care for it as much as I do, eight health behind a red die on a Gav tank works awfully well. And it's so short, you can still get cover and line of sight block on the Gav tank.
Yeah.
I don't think you'll be able to do that with the Persuader tank.
No, because it's going to be too tall.
Yeah. And also, I've the past couple episodes, I've made a point, and I've done it poorly myself. I don't want to get into the comparisons too terribly much, especially with some of the other news we got, that we're getting a whole refresh very, very soon. And for some of those older units, sure. We don't know what they're going to look like in 2 months' time.
But here's the thing, though. I've always said that people are sleeping on the Gav tank. Like, I do and still I think they're sleeping on the Gav tank.
Yeah.
That's okay.
I've never used one, I wouldn't say.
That's
yeah. So last time
I've just killed them.
COVID canceled the game that we were going to go play in Texas. No, in LVO.
LVO.
So that would have been, you know,
yeah.
That'd been about a year ago now was the last time I played a Gav tank. But man, did I have fun with a Gav tank a year ago.
Sure. Oh yeah.
I had fun painting your Gav tank.
You did. My little Kroger containers look nice.
Yeah.
Repaint mine.
But yeah. Yeah. Super fun. And that, by the way, was just the news that we knew was coming. They're like, yeah, we're going to finish up the Kashyyyk.
We knew about that.
Make sure everyone knows
that's
what's
the last of the Kashyyyk wave. Yeah, cool.
Neat. Well, good stream, everyone.
All right, awesome. Great stream, everyone. See y'all next time.
We've had a good weekend. Good weekend, guys.
Great time.
Good game.
Well, thanks for joining us on your paint time, drive time.
This is why I do the outros well.
We'd gotten a trailer teasing this stuff on Thursday, actually. That's what it was. We got a trailer and some pictures. Because they wanted to tell us, without telling us anything, about the new mercenaries.
Yes.
Because they are a force that will be joining Legion.
Kind of.
They are a battle force that will be joining Legion, which we'll get to in a second.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
So we have some new words that'll mean different things here.
Right. So mercenaries are units that can work for one or more of the main factions. Who they work for is listed. It's going to be listed on their card right now. It's redacted. Fair enough.
Yep.
They're not a full-fledged faction in their own right, so you can't just take like all mercenaries, but you'll be able to kind of plug them into existing factions. And there's also going to be special kind of like mini factions called battle forces. Those I don't fully grasp these. Okay. I haven't watched the stream.
Do you want me to go for it?
Go for it. Yeah.
Please. I just watched the stream.
Go for it.
Okay. So. Part of what you said is not true, because
battle forces
are a specific list of units that are brought together or partially, still not sure about that part, that will get a certain bonus. For the mercenaries, you can field them all as the Shadow Collective, which will be led by the Darksaber-equipped Darth Maul, or just Maul.
Yep.
I'm proud of you for not choking on that, by the way.
Yes. And what that will do is make all these units that are working for separate factions otherwise kind of usable as a faction together.
Ah, I gotcha.
And there are certain things like Scum Maul, let's call him, that are only available when you bring this battle force. And I think the Maul DeLoreans are also only available in that.
Interesting.
List.
Okay. So it's like a mini faction.
Yes. Okay. And there might be more for it. Sure. Yeah. But what they have shown us for the mercenaries that work outside of that are the Pikes, which, I mean, by this card, that looks rebel-ish. Like, it's got the red. It's got
the but red. That could also be a red herring, so.
Aha!
Go.
A red herring.
I did it.
Okay.
So who knows?
Well, I say rebels because they're kind of like rebel troopers.
They are kind of like rebel troopers, yeah.
They are.
They have, you know, just your standard, their cores, four dudes in a squad, one health, one courage, surge block, no surge hit, white save. Seems like a rebel trooper. One black die, range 1 to 3, but they got stun batons for 2 white dice in melee.
Ooh. Not surging white dice.
Yeah, they have danger sense 2, which on a core unit and a bravery 1 unit seems interesting.
Yes.
But they do have outmaneuver, so you can cancel crits, dodge tokens with crits, or crits with dodge tokens.
Yep, that danger sense too is a weird thing because of self-preservation.
Yes, exactly. When checking whether you panic, you cannot use the courage of a unit that is not of the same affiliation as you. And so affiliation is another new word, and I'm assuming you're going to be checking their courage against another pike unit or a pike commander of a
mercenary. They will have symbols of who they work for, but they will also have a faction symbol that I believe will just be, these are pike units, for example.
Right.
So they cannot check things that are like, even if they're in a rebel list, they cannot check the rebel commander.
Yeah. They have a pretty standard upgrade bar, heavy personnel, gear, grenade. But they have another keyword that when I saw this, I was like, rebels need this. This, this is neat.
You cannot have at
all. They don't need
you
that.
Cannot
you
cannot
have a nice thing.
Oh my God. Like you don't have any nice things.
Independent dodge one. Anytime they don't have an order, they get a dodge token. This is this is a cool reverse on what we've been seeing for the past year and a half in Legion, where we're passing out tokens with orders. Right. Now we're giving orders, or we're giving bonuses for units that don't get them, and you can plan your strategy around that.
And that's good because if you're not affiliated with these guys, under normal circumstances, you cannot order them from a commander that is not affiliated. There is going to be an upgrade that lets you do it. I think it's called Underworld Connections.
Yes, it is. It's like it sounds and like so an upgrade or a command upgrade, I imagine.
It lets you issue orders to mercenaries that are not affiliated. So if you're bringing them and you weren't going to order them anyway, cool, free dodge.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Neato.
Yeah, they seem pretty cool, and they also gave us two personnel and two heavy weapons.
Yeah, this is interesting because we have what seems to be the usual, you know, extra guy.
Mm-hmm. Right,
he is a dude. He is a Pike Syndicate Foot Soldier upgrade.
And
add one
it,
Pike
right?
Syndicate Foot Soldier mini.
That's all there is.
Well, no. You also gain a new keyword.
Ooh,
cash.
I'm excited for this. Yes.
Yeah.
Cash aim one. During setup, place one aim on the card, and you can spend it off of this card at any point.
Cool.
And
so cool.
Since he's just a goon in your squad, you have the keyword even when that mini in particular is defeated.
Right.
Yep.
So you don't have to try to track who extra guy is the whole time.
Which is so
free aim
such a nice
one
touch.
Time you need it, somewhere later we gotta do other stuff. I love it.
And he costs 9.
Yeah, he's pretty.
So
now we don't know how much the unit costs,
but how much is a rebel trooper upgrade?
7.
Eight? 7. Okay.
Yeah.
So a free token. I mean, I could see them costing 42, 40. Like
yeah.
But if it's
being about the cost
more
of rebels,
a name token off that base.
I think they'll be a little bit more expensive, because they do have danger sense, outmaneuver, and independent.
Like a lot of stuff.
Yeah, maybe that 9 is about right, and they'd be...
I'm thinking they're going to be like 45, 50 points.
And they did say on the stream, that they plan on using cash more moving forward.
Yeah.
Sure.
Now, to go back to what I was talking about a minute ago with Rebels and Independent, you know, clones, troopers as a keyword has cool baked-in rules. It kind of, that makes their army thematic. Droids obviously have their things the chaining of orders, but then also not caring about suppression. I would love to see Rebels get independent and Imperials get cash sprinkled over a lot of their forces.
So if you rewind, it's probably a few episodes. It's actually a long time ago now that I think about it. But I've mentioned this idea before, is if there was some way we could save aims from turn to turn, that would be a really cool Imperial keyword. I know this is not the exact way that works, but you could toy with this a little bit and easily
it's
make
one
it
freebie.
As such.
Yeah, you could use it in the Empire to represent their limitless resources that everybody's going into the field with all their gear and stuff.
They're and strapped.
Just, yeah, and you could obviously, like, this is, it's aim, it's cash, semicolon or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Aim
just
one.
Colon,
whatever.
Yeah.
Aim one. So it is a number.
It's an X.
It's an X, exactly. So X could, in fact, give it to you if you're the Imperials one day. They didn't say they're going to use it for the Imperials, but they, I mean, it seems like a perfect fit.
So my only problem with your plan, Ryan, is giving independent dodge one to rebel troopers who have nimble.
No, and I'm talking about
seems a little hard.
Independent as not necessarily independent dodge, but just the idea of independent getting sprinkled certain places.
Yeah, yeah.
Like because, maybe if there was an independent that did a different token.
Yeah, exactly.
Like on the other personnel upgrade, the Pike Syndicate Capo.
Oh yeah,
El Capo.
He is a Pike Syndicate Capo. You add a Capo to the squad.
That's racist.
And then your courage is increased by one.
That's huge. That is,
yeah, it is
huge for these
especially for all the
you know, just almost, increase your courage by one.
Almost feels like an auto include if you're taking these guys.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Because you also gain independent surge one if you're not ordered. That's... You may also gain a surge token.
And they did say if you have multiple independent keywords, they all
I would imagine they stack.
They all stack. Yeah.
So surge one and dodge one. With bravery 2, danger sense, surging white defense die.
Yeah.
Yep.
I think they're going to be okay. And outmaneuver. Like, I think they're going to be okay.
Now, Ben, you might be saying, but that's only like 4, maybe 5 black dice. Well.
Yeah. It's not a lot.
What do you know? You could bring a heavy.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Such as the P-13M disruptor rifle soldier.
Yes.
Those are illegal.
Yes, disruptor rifles, highly illegal.
It's range 1-4. Of course it's illegal.
Yeah, it's 1-4, red, black, black.
Yeah,
that's impact cool. one.
Impact one seems one's good. Nice.
Why not?
And
why not?
There you was know? some hubbub about bub that it a had bub-bub? Yes, that it had immobilize on it. It does not have immobilize on it.
That's on something else.
Yeah, we'll get there in a second, but like everyone was freaking out, like, oh my god, a range 4 gun with immobilize. Which would be gross, but that does not.
Yeah, that would not be gross.
I'm glad that's not real.
Let me be honest. With that.
They're super impassioned about playing the game on stream.
Yeah.
They don't know it well enough sometimes to realize what they've made things. I mean, and I get it, in part because they have played with different variations and versions.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they have to really read the cards when they're talking. And like Ryan Slowoski, who doesn't read the notes as we have them in front of him,
never.
He just says stuff and praises in the right direction.
Yep.
Yeah. So on stream, they
60% of the time, I'm good though. 60% of the time.
60% of the time, he's right every time.
I'd run those numbers, but I don't want to listen.
They are. Yeah, so the stream had some mistakes in it. It's fine, guys. It doesn't mean they don't know what they're doing from a design standpoint. It just means that it's hard to stream and play the game and think about it and talk about it cogently at the same time.
Yeah,
and they were doing 3 days of streaming and
for different games. So while you're having to do Legion and then X-Wing and then MCP and then everything else. Yeah. So
I played on a stream at a North American Championship in X-Wing, talked to the stream the entire time saying, listen, guys, I know I'm fucking up. My bad, guys. I know I'm messing this up. Yep, you're right. I did that completely wrong stream. Yep. Stop yelling at me. I haven't even looked at my phone. Stop.
We were worried about immobilize.
We were worried about immobilize. This guy is 24 points. So he's a bit of a chunk, but I mean, he's got some good.
But that's kind of on par with some of the other big range impact guns.
I think he's fine.
It's a DLT sort of.
It's a better DLT really, but yes.
Yeah, actually.
Yeah, it really kind of is.
It really
especially
is.
If you got that surge coming from the
gun.
Now, they spent a lot of time talking about how this was like the first gun they had designed. Like independent, because it doesn't exist in any of the things we've seen from the
results. They did a great job going into detail on the design work through a lot of this. Like, some of the weapons on that infantry thing for the Republic were never in Star Wars before, and this rifle wasn't before, and they had to, like, base it off of their pistols and things. And it's neat to see that kind of discussion.
Yeah.
Gonna be real honest, it looks a lot like a phaser rifle from Star Trek Voyager, but...
Well, nothing is original, so cool. Anyway.
We do have the weapon that I'm probably really excited about.
Terrified of for me, but yes.
Yeah. the Electro Whip Soldier.
Jesus.
Melee to range.
Watch
one.
Me whip.
2 red dice, immobilize, and suppressive.
What? 10 points.
Why?
And remember, guys, he can use a normal gun. He's not sidearm restricted, so he can still count as just, you know, your extra guy, which is just 9 points. So really, you're paying 1 point to give up cash aim, but to get this monster of a melee weapon.
Well, why not pay 19 weapon. And have both? I don't know.
Yeah, you can have both. Or you can pay 26 and have the leader and the electro whip guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Throw six black dice.
Pretty bonkers. And we don't know, granted, the list building restrictions on this, but if you're allowed to take 2 to 3 of these,
oh my god,
I think you don't need an answer for melee anymore.
No, because like, you are the answer to melee.
You are the answer. That's, yeah, getting able to tie down a Luke or a Sabine or a Maul
or a Vader,
and they have grenades. Yeah. So what Vader. If your range one attack was all red because you brought the crit grenades?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yes. What if it was 7 red dice for fun and profit?
So
with a mobilized suppressive surge crit.
Real strong. Real strong.
So yeah. And the fact that it's, you know, is range one or melee. Yeah. Like so Cad Bane's, you know, electro gauntlets, he does suppressive, he does immobilize 3, he has 4 red dice. I mean, he does, but it's 10 points and it taps.
Yep.
So it exhausts itself. You got to spend up. Like, this guy doesn't.
Yep.
So if you just happen to have 2 or 3 core units running around just whipping people left and right.
Yep.
I mean,
Cad Bane, more like Cad Bitch.
Got him, Jim.
Yeah, Cad Lame is the better joke there.
No, I got it better.
Chalk up a point for me.
It's a really good unit. So I love the idea of these mercenaries getting to play. I mean, they are parts that I really liked. It was a solo movie. I mean, it's just, yeah.
Yeah.
I liked it. I like these cards a lot.
Yeah.
And then not only do you get to see the actual foot soldiers, you even get their commander, who is the Pike Syndicate Capo, because, you know, like we do with the T1 series.
Yes.
We, again, don't get to see his point costs. It is redacted there, but he is, you know, he is their leader.
He has a command slot and a gear slot.
Yep. He has a symbol and a word that I think has been blanked out, but it's when you would gain an aim, dodge, or surge token, another friendly mercenary unit at range 1 and in line of sight may gain that token instead. If they do, you gain 1 suppression token.
It's called
aim. I believe that is the pike symbol as well.
Yeah.
It is awfully amazing, in part because you get to choose the token that you're going to go share. Yeah. So it's not like, oh, I'm Imperial, take this aim. Oh, I'm Rebel, take this dodge.
Yep.
You get to choose it. It's bolster, but better.
Yeah.
And it just turns on your danger sense.
It turns on the danger sense. Mm-hmm. And as you know, as Ryan and both Will can talk about, you both play Jin, just sometimes, hey, look, that paid out really nicely. Thank you.
Yeah, danger sense, once you learn how to operate it and force your opponent to nickel and dime units, if you don't get deleted off the board immediately, it can get real frustrating to deal with real fast.
I prefer uncanny luck, but that's just me.
And he does have that independent dodge 1, so you'll be able to do this from the get-go of start passing out dodge tokens.
Yep.
So that means if you have an unordered Pike Syndicate Capo commander and a, you know, just a Pike Syndicate trooper unit, that means that trooper unit is probably starting the turn with 2 dodges.
Yep.
I mean, yeah. Oh. And like all the basic, you know, capos, you know, with all the basic leaders, it's got 4 health. It's got 2 courage value, white defense die, surging to block. He's got 3 black dice, range 1 to 3.
Range 1 to 3, like the Rebel officers and Imperial officers are still range 1-2. So this guy's got a small firepower advantage if he's not hiding behind a rock that he probably is.
Right.
Yep.
I mean, I just love it. And the thing is, that's not the only mercenary unit they showed us. Oh. Like, these are the cards they showed us.
These are the cards.
But then they showed us the bodies.
The bodies have hit the floor.
Yep.
Hit the rendered computer
in. The render floor.
It is render. These aren't ratchet printed.
The render floor.
Now, you know me. I'm a man of Trek, not Wars. So I don't know this race.
The first image you have in our notes, this looks like it's going to be our good friends, the Black Sun. And we're going to get some Caesar and his friends.
Is it Caesar?
It's Caesar and it's Prince Caesar and also another Faline.
Yeah, it's. Do we know that this is Prince Caesar? I mean,
he has not made his appearance.
They did not say he was Caesar. They said he was a Faline. That was all.
I'm pretty sure he is the new canon somewhere in the background.
Okay.
And right, he is. So, some better nerd than me can correct me on that, but I'm pretty sure he is.
Here we go.
Who's read the books?
So season 7 of Clone Wars, Maul is talking to some folks, and they are on hologram, and one of them seems to be very similar, if not Zizor. He's very similar looking.
Sure.
It's Ziza.
And then like the villain from Solo is also there, so that's kind of a cool nod that he's got these connections.
I mean, anyway. I just love the armor on these models. And again, they've done such a great job with these renders.
Pauldrons!
I mean, yeah.
I'm curious what they're going to call those pistols. I think
it might be safe to say, if we can make such bold predictions, if the Pikes have a red unit card that might indicate that they are more rebellious in nature, I think it's going to be safe to say the Black Sun has some close ties with the Empire.
Well, and so
they're going to have some red box.
Looking at these renders as well, we have their main gun looks like a cool, like, plasma pistol looking thing, and then
it looks like something from Halo.
Yeah, and then like the two,
he really does.
That's the plasma pistol.
A double
yes.
needler.
Yeah. But then also we see a guy with a grenade belt throwing a grenade. Yeah, grenade, and then also a guy with what I can only assume to be a space Tommy gun.
That's the scatter gun, sir.
Oh, is it? Okay,
I think it is.
I don't have it enhanced. Fleet trooper scatter gun.
It looks like the side handle from the fleet guy.
Yeah. Okay, it fair enough. Like the shotgun. Okay.
Yeah, so that could be two red pierce one to two, maybe.
That's cool.
Shotgun grenadier.
Probably two red, two white, pierce one, critical one for less points.
But gentlemen, are these the coolest looking render mercenaries that we've seen? Are these the coolest ones? No, they're not.
No.
Spoiler alert, everyone. They're not. They're not.
No. I love the horny Mandalorians.
Oh, God, they're so good. Their spikes give me strength.
I mean that they have horns, obviously.
Yes, clearly.
What else would I be? Yeah.
So, I don't know what they do, but we see only one of them, no, two of them, excuse me, have a jetpack in the renders. Yep. Yes. Three. I'm trying to see if I'm four. Okay, so there's many jetpacks.
Okay, the rebel ones all have jetpacks. There are just some that are aerial
posed.
The more I
keep looking, yes.
Yeah.
Control plus sign, Tim. Control plus sign. We'll zoom.
Yeah.
I trust my young eyes, Ben.
No, you don't. You turned 30, Tim. You can't see anything. You've been making stuff up for the past 30 minutes.
Keep in mind that these were... they said these were only usable when you brought the Shadow Collective as a whole thing with Maul.
Yes.
Delicious.
So, but they could also be some delicious alts for Rebel Mandalorians if you really wanted to. If you wanted to have evil guys with your rebels for whatever reason.
Yeah.
Keith, you could.
Looking at you.
Yeah.
Listen.
Tim.
You know, there are people like Keith, and I'm going to speak to him right now. He has always wanted a Mandalorian army.
Oh, he hit my inbox real quick after this got announced, absolutely. And I was busy at work.
And he doesn't understand how to play lightsaber users, but you know what? He'll figure it out with Maul.
He's going to figure it out. Well, and so maybe this is a good spot to mention, too. So the Maul, which we saw spoiled before, the Maul, they said they have two configurations, and just to relax people's minds, not in a, like, what you see is what you get kind of way, but in as far as, like, what upgrades you equip with him, if you give him either his lightsaber, which we all know he has, or the darksaber, it will change his battlefield role and how that plays out. So it's not just like, oh, here's one melee weapon, here's another melee weapon. Evidently, it will change other things about him. That's all
I believe. I believe the commander of the Shadow Collective Maul will have the darksaber.
Yes, and, I think that's right.
There may be a new operative, or you could use this for the old operative to have the
robo legs. I still usual need spider
four
leg
white, four
Maul,
red.
No. I was really hoping for spider legs.
I know, me too.
Spider leg Maul on the STAP vehicle base would be pretty funny. Speed 2 unhindered reposition.
Now, still not. They're still not the coolest, though. I'm sorry, they're not the coolest models they've shown us, though.
Oh, God.
What could you be referring
to?
Hold on.
Because this model and the next model, which I think you're about to talk about.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Tac rocks.
It's all tactical.
It's all tactical rocks.
That's how you can always tell it's a an AMG product. It's all action rocks, people on rocks, standing on rocks, launching from rocks.
It's Boba. Dad Boba.
It's Fat Boba.
It is Dad Bod Boba.
Yeah. Don't even try. Yeah.
I actually really like this pose. I mean, I do with the gaffy stick, of course.
And the delicious deets that he is a rebel character.
Yeah, he's gonna be a rebel character.
But also,
he's not a mercenary.
He's wiser.
Well, and also that Boba is going to be coming with a redesign that it sounds like it's like a total redesign, which is nice because he's a bit
old. So what they said was that Boba, they said Boba, Bosk, and Cad Bane will be getting new cards to allow them to be a mercenary unit.
Sure,
which will mean they have new interactions and different rules, but that means they work for perhaps more than what they currently work for.
Yes.
And that'll be neat.
When they release these battle forces, they will also supposedly release a card pack so you can kind of upgrade those three models that you already have them.
Right.
As you need to.
Which I do.
Yep.
So I knew these were not the things Ryan was talking about because Ryan has always had a deep-seated love for a certain race of characters in the Star Wars.
It's a certain vehicle.
It's the vehicle.
Yeah.
You're thinking this is Harrison Dula riding this bike.
No, it's not. But we get Twi'leks on Step Rider. So Ben, you don't know this.
And Swoop.
Tim, I believe you do. Our good friend Spencer, many years ago, GM'd an RPG, and I was a giant white Wookiee who just was a samurai on his Swoop bike, and we have jousting Swoop bikes coming, and I am so
we have no idea what
excited.
No idea what they do. We just have them.
We have a picture.
Oh, we have a picture, but they appear to have melee weapons. So
but I'm saying we don't have the card or anything. Like, they didn't say it's going to do this.
I'm so excited.
Definitely has a vibro axe.
If we can get Chamsem Dula's forces for either the Republic or the Rebels, that would be awesome. I'm super stoked.
So these were just renders they gave us, but we found out even more news about this about these battle forces.
Yes, we did.
Crazy to me.
Oh, we did.
Because it won't just be the Shadow Collective that we'll be getting.
No. We're going to be getting more scenarios and more battle forces that will be Hoth-themed. So you're going to have Empire and Rebels Hoth-themed units.
Yep.
And then also some Clone Wars ones, which they didn't say exactly which battle, but they did say it was 501st and Droid Invasion Force, which I don't know what that means, but we'll see.
Yeah.
So some kind of... I hope it's the Droid Invasion Force is... I would love to see the Battle of Naboo.
That'd be cool.
Like the episode one, like AATs, Destroyers, and B1s. You get bonuses for taking those, and STAPs.
Yeah, but the 501st weren't there, though.
No, but the 501st was... Yeah, you got like the two ends of the trilogy. You got the opening and the closing.
Yeah. I can see that.
And then a Blizzard Force.
Yep.
That's the Hoth one, yes.
Yeah, Echo Base.
Hoth Defenders and Blizzard Force. Yeah.
Yes.
So I don't know if these battle forces are maybe going to tweak if they're going... Because obviously we're not going to get just a bunch of new Hoth units, but if it'll reward you for taking like FDs, Vets, and Tawns, and E-Webs, and
I believe that's the ATSDs. Idea. And it's also... I mean, they're boxes, like bundles of units that come out.
Oh, they're going to be new, not just like, here's a prepackaged, like...
Yes.
Thing that slots into your army list, it's going to be a box set. Okay, that's cool.
I mean, it helps people we'll get both. Into these older factions, and...
Right.
And it lets you buy in without the who do I sell this other half of the core set to kind of thing.
It's without paying the core set.
And it gives you a kind of framework to start list building from when it's like, well, you get a bonus to having these things, and here's a few of them. Go get more. Mm-hmm. And then you can still add maybe this or that. I don't know.
Yeah, the thing I would actually love to see AMG include in these new sets, any of these box sets, whether it's a card upgrade pack that they've talked about that's going to come, or these box sets, is I would love to see core set commanders, unit and upgrade and command cards. Because as soon as we get those, you no longer have to buy a core set to split out.
Yeah.
Well, funny you mentioned that. Inside the Battle Forces boxes, there's going to be giving other players access to brand new command cards specific to that Battle Force.
Yes.
Sweet.
So,
yeah.
And the Hoth Battle Forces will be getting... Echo Base and the Blizzard group, they'll be getting their own specific command cards.
That's and cool. not only that, they also teased some things, and these are... So I guess we should take a pause here maybe and say they did say that they are looking 18 to 24 months out into the future
this is not this year, this is next year at the soonest probably.
Right, but it's good for individuals that had some concerns about the future of the game. I know there were a few. And so it's to say that this game is looking out to the horizon and about as far out as you'd want them to look. You really don't want them to look too much farther out than this because it's kind of just too much to plan ahead. So it's good to have a long-term vision, which is good. It's not just, I guess we'll release this, I guess we'll do this, yeah, I guess we'll make this. There's a lot of thought and time and effort getting put into this. And they teased Mandalorian-themed things. We'll get Mando, I mean, that's IG-11. Well, yeah, but it's still nice to hear officially. Like, we're going to get Mando, IG-11, Moff Gideon, Dark Troopers, which I'm looking forward to. See, Dark Troopers.
Tim, you can get your droids now in your faction.
Yes.
So yeah.
Yes. More stuff, I mean, for Biston to ion is all I hear.
They'll still be eaten by Operative Luke, so it's fine.
But then there's the most important thing.
Oh, God.
Two very important things.
2023.
Yes.
Or 2023.
Yeah.
To go with Mandalorian, we had an Ahsoka reference.
Yes.
It's like, all right, you told it best, Will. Go ahead and tell the story. Like, it was just so, like, what the?
Will, you know, they're doing this stream and Will Schick is getting yelled at to kind of wrap it up. And so he's going through the thank yous. He's getting the sign. He says, like, well, thank you everyone for listening and being a part of this stream. Ahsoka confirmed, and have a good night.
yeah. I love it. I love it.
Yeah.
That's so good. So that's a great way to end your stream.
If you're doing a Mando, if you're doing IG-11, you gotta bring Ahsoka in. I mean, I don't even care which version of it is.
It really doesn't Ahsoka, matter. Honestly.
Yeah.
You know, ex-Padawan Ahsoka.
We'll probably have a couple versions, I imagine. Ahsoka. Yeah, we'll probably have a few.
And then, to celebrate the anniversary of Return of the Jedi.
Great. Yub yub.
We
have yub yub. Ladies and gentlemen, we have yub yub.
We have Ewoks.
The yub yub has landed one day.
I haven't painted a lot of rebels in a long time, but
I can't wait for the Ewoks to be stronger than the Stormtroopers.
And the Wookiees.
That's right.
I mean, now that we have a Fluttercraft, I can actually fly, a kite Ewok. I mean, that's
right. Oh, yeah.
That's right.
I'm ready for a support unit that's two kite Ewoks on, like, speeder bike bases.
They just drop rocks, so I guess it's black, white.
It's like two red overrun three, like, blah, 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 blah.
And it should be stated, too, in addition to all this future news that we're looking forward to, that's advanced spoils, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
Hints of spoils. They also said on the more, maybe I guess more concrete side, they reinforced what they had already said when they first put out an OP article. But there's been a lot of kind of speculation. That was a while ago, kind of a lot of hemming and hawing, like, well, what's the future look like for those of us that want to play in organized events and things like that? And they said that they are continuing to support OP. They are dedicated to continuing to support OP in the future, but also narrative OP, which, again, we've talked about on this podcast several times. That's fine, but they still want to do the traditional tournament setup as well, which is music to my ears.
So I love this, but I am going to say, AMG, if you're listening, or if someone who's related to someone at AMG is listening, the event y'all just had in the middle of Mini Extravaganza is awesome.
Yeah.
If you had given us like a 1 week
heads up,
we perhaps would have done
give
a
us
thing
time.
Yeah. Over the weekend.
This is the second time they've done that to us.
Yeah.
And I would love to run one of those events as one of our monthlies.
Play that. It's cool.
Giving us 72 hours to play three games of Legion is...
That's not realistic.
It's tough, especially in the middle of Invader League season. Like, come on, people.
And COVID season.
In the middle of Invader League. It's one of those people have weekends and things. Yeah. I still couldn't have played this weekend. I had class all weekend. But maybe I could have gotten a game on Sunday.
No, but I'm definitely filing that PDF away for
our season. Sure.
I've saved
for
it already.
Sure. Yeah.
But if you give us a heads up, we will celebrate the cool thing you're doing, AMG. And I know sometimes, some of the OP conversation, you just got to give the players enough lead time and they will do amazing things for you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just give us a heads up. We'll do it. We'll take care of it. Just give us notice.
We'll tag you in all of our Instagrams and all of our Twitters and all the beautiful photos that we see.
And they said they're going to keep up with traditional OP too, which is nice. So that would be good. And that includes Adepticon. We weren't quite sure because X-Wing and other things have been announced for Adepticon, but we're like, what about Legion? And they said there should be Legion at Adepticon 22.
Won't be Worlds.
No, it will not be Worlds.
They said as much.
Worlds is, they want to do Worlds, but they don't feel comfortable yet.
They want to make sure everyone in the world commit, because you can't, it's like calling
if you're inviting
the winner
people,
of the World Series. It's not real the World Series, really. It's the American Baseball Series.
Like, the Canadians have a team, sir.
Okay.
They're allowed to win.
That doesn't include the whole world. So, yeah.
And they
so
have, they don't, haven't they?
They have on occasion. We don't talk about that, though. But So I appreciate that. And they said that, as they said before, it will continue to honor the old invites that Ben doesn't have. But they will continue to honor
that Tim doesn't deserve.
But still has. But still has. It's not deserve or not deserve. It's have or have nots, and I have. So
that's second.
That's a bold statement from coming from to someone who's got earned two of them from someone that's got none, Ben.
We all know that second one shouldn't have been a thing. You should never have been able to roll four paint on those white
I was allowed to roll the dice, and so I rolled the dice.
No matter what happened, I won that game because I got my invite.
Because you done did me dirty, Tim.
That's really it. Like, there's nothing but salt that weekend. That I could hear it.
I wasn't salty. I don't know what you're talking about.
Good time.
All your opponents were, though. I heard three salty people in that.
See, that's why I want real.
So, I mean, it'll be nice to hear about Legion Adepticon.
Yes.
You know, they opened up the hotel suite. It was sold out within about 3.5 minutes.
Yes.
We currently have a very nice 2-bedroom suite just across the interstate.
Yes.
We can't walk it, but you know, it's not bad. It's fine.
It'll be very nice. It'll be fun. I'm glad that they'll have it.
OP doesn't really do a lot for us unless we get, you know, some kind of points adjustment. And we haven't had one in a while. Yes. We've talked about this podcast.
We had one in December.
Discord.
Yeah,
we definitely need a meta shift.
Yes.
We definitely need a meta shift. We need some things that were
poke it with a
little
stick.
Tuned.
Yeah.
Just get a little poke. So they did announce that they have one. They're in the works of testing it.
Yes.
It'll come out in the next month or two.
Yes.
Which is honestly a lot sooner than I was expecting.
Yes.
Yeah, you're expecting me much longer.
I was expecting January, so, yeah.
I'm okay that they're playtesting it. They're talking about it. In fact, on the stream, they're looking at things. They're messing with it. They even gave us lists, but they didn't tell us what the point costs of those lists were.
Right.
As they were kind of showing off the new pikes some other changes they had made.
Yes,
so we can look forward to that.
Yes.
I mean, we can. So, so dear listeners, you do have that coming. And there will be a change
in that
document.
So part of the thing they were playing with the other day was the Dark Lord himself, Mr. Vader, sir. And, you know, anyone who's played Mr. Vader, sir, recently knows he's a little, you know, his joints are a little rusting. You know, his cortosis armor is not quite as shiny as it used to be. And it's been a little rough.
Cortosis, he says.
And so they have spoiled several things about new updated Vader. Oh, there's a good amount here to try and tackle. So, and you might actually have to correct me if I miss something here. But they said that new Vader, Commander Vader, will have a command slot.
Which is bonkers.
Which is so good.
It's bonkers that he didn't have it before. Come on. Yeah, it's bonkers that he didn't have it.
Yeah, but Vader's, I think, his biggest problem, his two big weaknesses are his speed, which is getting fixed probably around the time the points update comes out with
burst of speed. It's not fixed, but okay, yes.
And also his survivability. Granted, he is, you know, has a ton of health, but he's also a ton of points and paired with his speed. But you give him a command slot and toss a steamed leader onto him.
He can be maybe viable.
Be scary.
He can be maybe viable finally. Yeah. It'd be a great big change of pace.
A steamed leader actually is more terrifying to me.
Yeah.
A steamed leader is great. Just about all the other cards.
Well, and you don't necessarily need to put AT on him because they also said that they're going to be changing Darkness Descends. And there's been a little bit of a hiccup here because I don't know exactly how they're going to do it because they said one thing and then it said another thing on here. So we'll figure out exactly what it lands on. But basically the way they said it is that Darkness Descends has changed, that if you don't divulge it, it becomes a permanent reliable 2. Now, it could also mean that someone has said that in watching the stream again, and Will, since you watched it recently, you might be able to chime in on this, that it required him to have an order. But that doesn't super matter because he's probably going to have an order all the time anyway. So that's
you're
fine.
That close,
so even if it's even if his reliable is reliant on an order token, that's fine. Like I don't, it doesn't super matter.
Yeah. So you either get infiltrate and scout or reliable too,
and you're going to take reliable too if you want to live.
Yeah.
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 Yes.
I think it's. You know, we have the existing card that says when he's issued an order, you gain 2 surges.
Yes.
And I think it's just going to be permanent. That's a key. That's a thing.
Right. Which is fine.
When he's issued an order, you gain 2 surges.
And that's fine. It's might as well be reliable too, because you're probably going to be giving an order. I do wish it was standard reliable too, because that does. I like to, you know, sometimes change it up a little bit. Be like, oh I'm not going to order Vader. Surprise. Ha ha. But it's fine.
And granted,
I'm not harping.
this was done on a stream in which they did not have corrected cards to show off. They were going off their playtest in their head to kind of show off some changes and the new Pike unit.
And I'm happy either way, so I'm really not... I'm not too picky about it.
Reliable was something we'd talked about Vader maybe getting to
So help him out. Okay. And then also, they're going to give... I guess back to the keywords. I realized I forgot a keyword. He's going to get Compel Core Trooper.
Which is terrifying.
Terrifying on a...
It is.
On a courageless unit.
Ding,
ding, ding.
Yep. Courageless. Now, with a command slot, Compel Trooper.
I love the cinematics of this.
Yeah.
Because if you manage to kill Vader, the army will rout. Because they're all going to have 17 suppression on them.
Well, a couple of them will. Yeah, for whoever's getting compelled all the time.
Compelled forward,
I love seeing this idea with that Blizzard Force. You put him on Hoth.
Which is now going to say, and this is also huge, at the start of each activation and the Implacable turn, which Implacable can give you up to two activations, you get a dodge token. Which is so good.
So he's getting a dodge token every turn?
Yeah. No. During the Implacable. Gotcha. Yeah. So potentially two free dodges.
Yeah.
Assuming you activate twice. Yeah. Unless he dies before his second activation.
Because that happens pretty often.
And then Vader died. I did that at Dallas. But yes.
Because you have to. It's a ticking clock. Like you have to kill Vader.
Yeah.
Or,
yeah.
you know.
Yeah, but that's the thing, though, is that now Vader's going to have a free dodge. Which is great.
Which means
he'll have deflect. Yep. So it's
and he's going to have stormtroopers to throw in front of his bullets.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Who might also have esteemed leader, or he might have esteemed leader.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Yeah. Because I think esteemed leader is like maybe extending his courage bubble to range 4 for
it's not
that.
Bad. It's not bad.
Isn't bad. But I think keeping Vader alive at the cost of 7 points or 8 point stormtroopers.
Yeah.
Is pretty accurate. Pretty groovy.
Yeah,
I'll be honest. The last time I saw Vader in a bunch of snows was the very first Gen Con, and it was hell to beat at that time. I would love to see that come back because it's so iconic on the table. That's how you get new players into this game.
And
oh my God, is that Vader and a bunch of stormtroopers? Yeah, it is, in fact,
absolutely. And snowtroopers. I mean, he gets to compel some snowtroopers. So Vader flames. Gonna be quite nice.
He's gonna get there. He's gonna get there.
And he'd still be able to riding. Vader Lat is viable. I'll give it that. Like, even right now.
Vader with Compel on snows is going to be terrifying because he can compel them to move. Yep. They take their free steady shot and then just take a dodge token and never die.
Yep.
Post up.
Well, or they just attack twice for their act. Like, he compels them and then.
Well, compel.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm thinking the wrong thing. Yeah, I'm thinking of. Shoot, I can't remember what I'm thinking.
Compel is the evil version of Dauntless. Yes.
Yeah.
Don't worry. I'll erase his bit. It's fine.
It's fine. Let Tim suffer in his sin. I'm not knowing the rules for those things that he hasn't used in forever.
Yeah, exactly. I have no ill feelings about this. I'm fine with that. Yeah. But no, it's very exciting to see. Did I miss anything with new Vader that we mentioned?
No, I think that's the high point.
That's it, yeah.
Yeah,
it's I'll be honest, I didn't have the Implacable bit. I never could find that. So I heard it. I just never could.
So the interesting thing too is that's all Commander Vader. I'm wanting to know, what do we see for OP Vader, for Op Vader? Let me see that. Let me see if we're going
to. I don't know if we'll get much, honestly, because unless we'll get the edits to the command cards that obviously he can play.
Right. 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 Which might be it, which is still really good for Op Vader.
Yeah, because I think Op Vader isn't in as bad of a spot as Commander Vader is.
I agree with that.
And we also don't know, we've talked about points update. Is Commander Vader going to go back up in points cost for all his new tech?
I hope not. That'd be such a low blow.
I would be okay with him staying the same.
Yeah,
if point costs
are a lot of it depends on what the other things move around him are.
Yeah.
Right. So
it's all dependent on what everything else does, which we don't know about. So
correct,
we'll see.
It's a lot of cool news. I guess the last big piece of news, if I'm not mistaken, is we alluded to it earlier. They are altering the deal. They're altering turn zero.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I think the way that we've talked about a lot of different ways to deal with it on this show. I was not, when this was first suggested to me, I wasn't the biggest fan of it, but I've come around to the idea over the past couple weeks and kind of sitting down and thinking about it. And we're just going to use the blue player's whole deck, shuffle it up, and deal all four cards.
Yep, deal all four.
Instead of pulling randomly one out.
It's not my favorite solution, but I think it's the most practical and it's probably the most balanced, to be fair.
I think it's the most practical this moment.
Yeah, exactly. It's not what I dreamed of, but I'm not mad about it for sure. I'm actually quite happy about it. Very, very happy.
So blue player can't control a column anymore to either get hemmed in looking at you, Kyle Dornbos, or a bombing run or hostage exchange skew. Will bids get reflected by it? Who knows? Yeah. But it does feel a little more fair.
In the one game I won in the tournament, we didn't get to talk about because Ryan blew up his computer.
Yep.
It was because I got the turn zero that I wanted. Yeah. He gave me all the pieces against the player who didn't need me to have all those pieces. And then I just sat there and picked them apart.
Well, and this also gives, I think, a little bit more power to red player as well. You know, being able to say, no, you can't do that. Or if, you know, let's just say if everybody just goes down the one track, you could be like, I'm going to force this, you know, at the back. I mean, I know that would take a lot of vetoes and things like that, but it's doable.
It is. It's definitely going to change turn zero up. And the cool thing is, this is something that we don't have to wait on them to do.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Like, it makes the most sense. It's an easy fix.
But like, if actually what I mean is, like, at your local game night, if this is something that you wanted to just start doing and practicing for, which I think you probably should.
Spoiler, I'm going to. any future opponents, I'm going to insist on this.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to stick to the battle deck as now for Invader League, and that's about it. And, this is really welcome news. If nothing else more, it means that they're listening, because this has been a big topic of discussion for the past, you know, well, really since organized play has come back from the dead after COVID.
It was immediately
a topic of discussion.
And so, if I can go off for a minute.
You may. This is all right. 25% your show.
Sure. I just want to point out that I think I see AMG changing things across their games in a way similar to this.
Yeah.
They're kind of lessening the known commodities you can control during pregame is what I think they're trying to do. They announced turn zero changes to Legion, Marvel, and X-Wing. And all of those changes are making it where a player can't really try to spin the outcome super in one way or the other before the game's even started, is what competitive players want to do. They want to mitigate risk and get the game going. Yep. They want to win as soon as they can, and if they can get to a heavily weighted thing before the game's even started, before minis are down, that's obviously a strong thing to do competitively judging. Like, that is correct to do when it's an option. And so they're moving away from that because I think there is, yes, that's the better choice competitively, but it something Tim would say a lot, and I agree with to some degree, it feels bad, man.
It does. It feels real bad.
It feels bad. Like, when you look at a matchup and you go, oh, you did it. Okay.
Yep. And like, okay,
I can fight against this, but it's uphill for me this entire time now because of how this has turned out.
Drastically
uphill, like when you're playing Rex against a Rexstar before Vans and before that wave of expansions, you know that they're going to have a bigger bid than you, so there's a 25% chance they get hostage and there's nothing you can do about it.
Right. Yeah. I think it's that when there was nothing you could do about it, they want to remove that. Because Marvel had an issue of kind of pre-programming where it's like, well, if you get these couple missions and you control priority, then you can go first turn, do this, play this card, do this move, and score like half the points you need to win the game on the first turn. Wow. And people math these out because they can do these precise moves and pre-measurements and kind of map it out through practice. And that's well and good. That's effort and good on them, but it's not fun. For the other person,
it's not fun.
It's not
like maybe it's fun to practice that out and find these exploits. Like some people like breaking games, and that helps. Like that just ticks a box in their brain. But for everyone else, it's like cool.
Everyone else has to go through that.
Thanks for ruining it. Is that
and it's interesting, encouraging. I don't know the right. I guess it's encouraging to see how much they were willing to look at and adjust X-Wing as well, because X-Wing, I would say, got the heaviest change.
Yeah, I think X-Wing got the biggest hammer by what they've said.
Yeah.
And I think that's because Marvel and Legion are at least an objective-based game that stalemating is not a solution that you can try to exploit as a player.
Right.
But that is something X-Wing has and still struggles with, is that when it's better to sit in the corner, like, what's the incentive to not do that? And there isn't any.
When it's more efficient to not play the game than play the game.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
Well, and that's exactly what they said, I think, in the stream, right? Of,
yeah.
We don't want people to just say, okay, I'm going to bring this because it's, you know, high agility or low agility, whatever they said in the stream. It's like, yeah, okay, I've won now and I have a big
game. Yeah. They want to remove auto wins. And so X-Wing, I mean, they're, bids no longer determine first player in X-Wing, and bids are, the deficit you have in your list is immediately scored by your opponent.
Yeah.
So
that's huge.
That's huge.
I've asked for that for Legion.
I agree with that. Yeah. You know, I'll cheer for that.
Works well. I hope it works well in X-Wing, and that's something maybe they poured over.
Well, and so people are saying, like, why both in X-Wing? And it's because even if, you know, first player's random, they could still try to bring a, like, two-ship list that's 150 points and bank the 50 points as unkillable points for themselves. Mm-hmm. So that you still need to disincentivize doing that in the list building phase as well. So it's I'm encouraged by what they're doing to X-Wing, because it's going to shake things up a lot, and that's going to make some people unhappy. But I think it's what the game has been needing, because it can get kind of just at a high level. It's been kind of dry.
Yeah. Well, and also now it's capped at 12 rounds. Like, the game is 12 rounds.
So one's a little less. They brought that up more in reference to how the core set rulebook of X-Wing doesn't have an endpoint besides everything's dead. Like, core set X-Wing doesn't have a timer. It says you kill your opponent.
Sure.
Yeah. So it needs a way for the game to end besides that, just to make the game more fun, because otherwise it's like, do you want to just stop? Is a question you have to ask.
Are you
and
done?
And it opens up what they want to do in X-Wing, which is start designing objective play in casual and competitive ways. So having a 12-round timer helps out with that a lot.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So I'm excited for
they're doing high level upgrades on, even though it's not our game, but it goes to show what they're willing to do.
I think they saw less to correct for Legion, which I think is true.
Which it's a younger game, in a way. I know, I think it's technically older than second edition, but second edition came with all the
it's a few months older than second edition,
it's nice to show that Legion is getting the adjustment touch on the spectrum somewhere in between X-Wing and Armada. That's got the death nail
hiatus.
It's not dead, but we're not developing right now.
We're just taking a break. It
might come back one day.
Yeah, letting the reprints catch up. That's fine. Not to go off a tangent, but I genuinely think it's fine. Because I just had all this new stuff come out for it. But okay, go ahead.
I think it's good to see that they want turn zero to still matter, but they want it to not create no win scenarios and things.
Yeah.
And so that was my main takeaway, honestly. Like, exciting news for a year and a half from now, but changes to game design that they're willing to make because they want to make these games long lasting and better experiences. Right. That's a good sign.
And like Ryan said, it means they're listening and they're willing to adapt, which is good.
Yeah.
There are certain companies that don't do that, and they might control a large portion of the wargaming market. But
It's
Games Workshop. Now that we said their name, they might take us down. We got to be careful.
Yeah, they might send us a
We've said their name. God forbid.
No, I've read their legal thing. We're safe for now.
for now. For a moment.
Yeah. They're not quite as litigious as certain religious groups.
Not until we start creating art or using sound material that would represent their universe.
That'd be heresy, dear brother.
We've not said the W word, so we've really not actually referenced anything they've created, just the fact that they're a company.
That's correct.
Just that they're a company.
And they do exist. I would not claim otherwise.
So that's right. And I do have some of their things on the shelf, and that's fine.
Mine are in a box over there.
I do think this is a very good place for AMG. This does scratch a little bit of the what about OP, what about OP.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
as parts of the nation are opening up, as other places have got their COVID under control,
right. yep.
there are people who are like, I want to get back out and play. And, you know, we had a tournament about a month ago now, and most of us were masked up, or we did a lot of hand washing. Those who weren't masked mm-hmm. up, like, we were very careful about it and distancing. And
yeah.
so, I mean, we're having tournament play out there.
Yeah.
And this is at least assuring them that AMG hasn't forgotten about it.
Right.
But it's also doing it in a very AMG style. Like, they do love narrative play.
Yeah.
yeah.
That is something they've liked. And FFG tried it at the very beginning and had some cool things, yeah. but it was AMG loves narrative play. Yeah.
And
so they're going to spend some time and effort getting into it.
And like I said before, and I'll say it again, I'm okay with organized narrative play. I think that's a cool space to be in, especially like they just did for Ministravaganza. Great. As long as you just keep giving me my regular OP as well. That's fine. We can have both. I want to live in that world. Mm-hmm. I want both. Just don't cost me my OP.
So, speaking of OP, we do have more OP things that yep. are going on this year before these rule changes may be happening. So that may be a thing that's going on.
Or but after. You know, who knows?
We've got our monthly tournaments going on. So mm-hmm. that's nice. We're in the middle of Invader League right now.
Woo.
Some of us are playing. Some mm-hmm. of us are just listening to people play.
Yes. That's two me. Of us are playing. The other two are you and Will. Yeah.
So, listen, but he and I have some very important things to do. Mostly living and going to school. So,
yes, I mean, to be fair,
no, what they mean to say is they're playing X-Wing, guys. They're playing X-Wing.
I've been skirting. I've been skirting. Messaging
Ben's
Ork.
Ben's too
like,
busy
buddy.
Editing our show.
yeah.
I keep telling Ork, like, I don't know if I'm going to make it, man. I don't know if I'm going to get this done. I got a deadline coming up.
So we do have other events that are coming up. We've talked about before. You know, we're talking about going to New Orleans here in December. And I hear that perhaps we've got some news about that.
We do have news on the New Orleans Open. This has been in the wings for a while. Some of you have probably puzzled it out. Others of you have not. But the New Orleans Open is happening the second weekend in December. Tickets, I believe, big asterisk here, are going to go on sale this Friday. So if you're listening to this in a couple of days. And I'm going to be your tournament organizer. So I'm super excited about that. I grew
September
up,
the 17th.
I grew up in New Orleans. And so it's going to be a fun reason to go home in December. The downside of it is due to hurricanes and viruses and pandemics and all of these other things, it is going to be a little bit smaller of a convention. It's not going to be an LVO. It's not going to be an ACO. But we are going to have our own ballroom, and it is going to be a 32-man capped event. We're going to do a fun event on Friday that is still in the works, and then a 5-round Swiss tournament over Saturday and Sunday. One ticket to the Legion event at the New Orleans Open will get you access to all of that. We're not going to parcel out the Friday event from the main event. You buy a ticket and you're in. And it's good. The venue is right downtown. I think we're like a block or two away from the French Quarter. So it is going to be a incredible time. Just
it's amazing
32
to
people.
Be able to get that place. Like
yeah,
that's a,
yeah. that sounds crazy.
New Orleans is a place to visit in December because mm-hmm. it's not 1,000 degrees and 100% right. humidity. So,
and I remember, you know, I'm so sad you guys didn't get to come, but in a couple years ago in St. Louis for Warfare Weekend, it was really fun because it wasn't jam packed, because there wasn't a full convention raging all around us. We had our own little Legion ballroom. I want to say there were like 40 or 50 people, and we all got to know each other really well. We didn't have to play on a huge time clock. We're going to have time to play games because we have 2 days to play 5 rounds. It's going to be a really fun time, and I hope you all can come and make it out. Yes. It's going
to
be cool.
I can't wait to hear about it. It'll be great. Good time.
The date for that, by the way, is December 10th, 11th,
yep.
and 12th.
Yes, I cannot wait to wave at you as I cruise by on the cruise ship.
And when he says this Friday, he means the 17th of September,
yeah,
potentially.
Ben already did that.
Yes. Did he do that?
He did.
I did do that.
I don't listen.
No one does. None of us listen to each other. We just talk. We all just talk, and somehow it works.
I listened because I had to listen to it 3 times.
Well, that's
true. So, although I will say, Ryan, you say that as though LVO wasn't exactly that. We had 56 players
at
LVO. We had a great time.
You mean LSO.
No one was stressed. No one was rushed.
LSO.
No, at LVO, wasn't it that many people per day?
Yeah.
And we had two playing
heats. Ben saying LSO.
LSO, sorry.
Oh,
yeah, I'm sorry. Gotcha.
Yeah,
I wasn't at LSO, so I don't get to
so many L's
experience from that.
So many L's. This is why we should stop abbreviating people. The Lone Star.
It's like Tim's Invader League record.
We don't abbreviate people.
So many L's.
But I mean, the Lone Star Open was exactly the right size. We knew just about everybody who was there.
Will, a W counts as A withdrawal counts as an L in my book. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
I don't know when your withdrawal date is for college, Tim, but I know it's soon, so well, think about it.
Yeah, yeah. Me and Matt are having that discussion right now.
With W. Yeah.
Solve for W. Withdraw. So, there we go.
Yep. Quit.
So if you Force haven't quit. Taken a look at our Instagram recently, you'll see photos from our last tournament, which we did not get to talk about, because this episode, because there's so much news, has gone so very long. But you should definitely check us out at STABcast. We can see all the pictures, all the tables. Since since Ryan's involved with the New Orleans Open, we'll be bringing some terrain pieces with us.
A lot of those tables are going to show back up there, yeah.
Yeah.
Some very nice design tables. And we have enough things to make those designs different. So most of our boxes can be arranged in many ways. So we don't really know what we've set up until we do it. So check us out at STABcast.
Be sure to check us out on the other social media platforms where we all have Facebook and Twitter. Rate us on the iTunes or subscribe on the Spotify or thumbs up on Google Podcasts, however that works. I don't know.
That works.
I don't know.
I did get an email. We should somehow sign up for Amazon Podcast. I don't know.
Ooh, fun. Even more RSS feeds for you.
I volunteer. We give Tim's kidney to Bezos.
Oh, nice.
That's true.
My whole house is already wired for that.
You can listen to us on YouTube of all places. It's currently listed underneath Ryan Slowoski because he didn't put it underneath the STABcast name, but cool, whatever.
It's fine.
But you can. Nepotism's our podcast fine. Goes out to the YouTube.
Does it? Interesting. Neat.
There were like 11 the YouTube listeners. Music,
right?
Wait, there's 11 people listening to via that service?
Yes.
Look at you go, 11 people. Cool.
All right.
Let us know who you are. Reach out to us. Let us know. Give us some love mail. And then also, speaking of love mail, you can find us on Discord, the Legion Discord. We are at.
I do get lots of love mail from that service. I'll be real honest.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what all of our usernames are anymore. I don't know. They're in green. It's either at STABcast whatever or Benston Churchill or Saint Tim of the Mines. There's a lot. It's a mess. Just tag something STABcast and someone will
be one of us.
Yeah, one of us will get it. That's fine.
Yeah.
We're also on streaming.
If you want to support. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
No. We're also on streaming services. Such as the Twitch and maybe the YouTubes. I don't know. Might reach out to there. I was hoping to be streaming some Invader League games, but I just have not had that time. And I would love to tell you that I will have time to do it because I miss streaming it. I have a great time doing it, but I have not streamed anything in a very long time. So I don't know if that'll be changing anytime soon.
But yeah, you can find Tim on either STABcast at Twitch or at Imitation Irish.
Yes, thank you.
If you're interested in the early morning streams, the Australians tend to start streaming about the time I get up on the East Coast in the morning.
That's true.
So sometimes you can watch Legion while brushing your teeth.
Which is nice. I can't believe he did that.
I know the West Coast is basically 12 hours off of East Coast time, so if they start games at 7 p.m., it's 7 a.m., so have fun.
I refuse to believe that the West Coast exists. Moving on.
Both of them or the Australian one?
All of them. Anything I don't see doesn't
very
exist.
Very nice James Brett, has never hit beat for me. In my last Invader League, he was playing this morning as I was driving into work. It was nice. I could listen to it.
They did all... the Colkey invited me to play on their server, and I just was not a... I didn't think I could commit time to Invader League. Otherwise, I would have signed up for the Down Under League.
They're a lot of fun down there. They're a lot of fun.
We all have fun down here.
If you want to support our show and not... Western Australia. You can check out our Teespring store at teespring.com/stores/STABcast.
You should support We Are Legion because they're cool.
You should support
Australia.
We Are Legion.
You can still get some fanny packs. I have no idea what the shipping to be to that would be.
It'd be $40 dues.
Now, I will say, hold on.
Now, Will's not invited back to it.
We should point out, too, I don't know if you guys are aware, gentlemen, we've not talked about this, but the fanny pack market has heated up a little bit. And, yes. And
did Fifth Trooper copy us?
No. This time it was our friends. Sometimes the knife that hurts the worst is the one in the back. And it's from our friends over at Six Up Supply. And they also have a fanny pack. So theirs is like a satchel. It looks a little bit different. I think you can have both. If you think I don't plan on having both next major event, you're wrong, because I 100% will.
I thought you were a deacon in the Church of Biscayne. This hurts my heart.
Listen, he's been stealing from the coffers. It's the most American
thing to have your pastor stealing from the
coffers. We're just trendsetters, which means we can start charging more for hours because it's the original.
That's right.
Yeah, that's true.
That's that right. True. If you want a signed copy, too bad. But yeah, that's fine.
Now we're haute couture.
But yeah, the Chanel of this.
I'm not even going to save this outro. Thanks for listening.
Sorry,
STABcast Couture.
Thanks for spending your paint time, your drive time, or whenever it is you bother to listen to this dumpster fire of a podcast.
House of STABcast.
Until next time, I'm Ryan Slowoski, reminding you should go sign up for the New Orleans Open in a couple days and/or the past.
And I'm Will Heim, reminding you that the infantry support platform is not a support. Don't get confused like I do.
Or is it infantry?
Oh, God. It's a clone trooper. Help.
It's not really a platform either. That's
true. No, it kind of moves.
Oh, man.
It does move.
Platform shoes kind of move a little bit. They aren't really platforms.
You know what they move?
I'm Tim Hannon, reminding you that I am, in fact, from New York. No matter what Will says, and just
I said
I'm not
you weren't
from
New York City.
I'm just outside the city. I can see the city from the train that I take into
don't,
it.
Don't call it the city.
It's the city. It is the city. All right, listen here.
You mean L.A.?
It's my home. It is my home, and it is dear to my heart.
Long Island is your home.
Long Island.
If you want to go to,
you live on Long Island.
You
go work in the city, and then you take the train out to Long Island. That's what you do.
Your mom's house is on Long Island. That's.
Because that way you can get to, you don't want to live in the city. You can't afford. I don't have enough kidneys to sell to live in the city. So you live on Long Island where you only have to sell one kidney.
And I'm Ben Fowler, reminding you that the first person to paint their Persuader class tank droid like Gary the Snail from SpongeBob, I will send you a personalized fanny pack from the STABcast.
Ooh. It'll have snails.
SWSTABcast@gmail.com. We need photos.
Yeah. Pixar didn't happen.
Yep.
Have a good night, everybody.
Goodbye.
It'll be Brett. He'll buy one just to say he'd done it.